Yes, sir.
One other thing that I need to address, man. And I don't know if you have conversations with guys before the battles or what, but it seems to me like RBE is the place to come when they want to talk that real talk, especially between brothers, friends. The third round that I seen tonight, and we could talk about Big Cannon versus Danger Zone. Like, yo, I did see Danger, like, you know, on no bitch shit, like, he really shed a tear when he was, you know, yeah, talking to Big Cannon about some Big Brother shit.
Yeah.
And it seemed like your platform has become that. Like, do you talk to the battlers, or do you just think, like, out of respect of just them watching and seeing what RBE means?
You know, I'm gonna use a classic example to paint that picture. A lot of people are familiar with Big Meech's interview when he broke down, you know, how a boss or a leader or the owner, whatever picture you paint, you know, is a reflection of the team. You know what I'm saying? So he said, he gave an example. Y'all go look it up, Big Meech talking that shit. You know, if you got a Robin-ass boss, you're gonna have a Robin-ass team. If you're gonna have a professional-ass boss, you're gonna have a professional-ass team. You know what I'm saying? He gave a real good breakdown of that. And to fold that into the picture that I'm really painting for y'all is that I think the vibe of RBE has always been genuine. Mm-hmm. Real guys that's gonna identify and relate to everything. It doesn't matter if you're over here trying to call somebody out for personals, or you getting on stage talking about you got shot, like they, like, you know what I'm saying, or talking about your health, like, oops. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You feel the vibe and you see how even we react to it. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So it's like, people know that they have that creative space over here to get into some real shit, some punchline shit, some image shit, whatever. They know they got that space over here, and the crowd helps with that as well. The people that come out to RBE events and them fucking with it, they help with that as well. And it's been happening since, I don't remember if it happened on our first event, but definitely happened on our second event. Mr. Mills did it with Oops when he was talking about the fight that had just happened with Diz and Matt. He had an opening round about the shit on our second card, Lift the Soul Part 1. Do the homework, it's on the channel.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So,
and then, you know, we got Daylight and Oops.
Got Daylight.
10 million.
Even Uno Lavos, when he battled Zer Money.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? On a 2-day event. He opened up one of his rounds like that. Yo, since I'm on RBE, can I talk that real shit?
Mm-hmm.
Because people feel that they can come over here and they have the open lane to do that shit. And not only is the league going to support it, but the fans is going to be open to it. Nobody's getting booed or none of that bullshit. It's a different aura that we create. So me, Shata, Lawrence, the team, the shooters, you know what I mean? Doc, man, everybody sets that vibe and that precedence to, like, yo.
Yeah, but not only that, like, yo, how do you come up with, like, the battles? I mean, how does nobody else think of Danger Zone versus Big Cannon?
I don't know.
I mean, like, how do you think about the matchups, bro? Like, it's just so different.
It's been like that since day one.
Yes.
Some of it.
You created Rookie versus Vets. Whatever the Abbey League is calling it nowadays. The Vet versus the Rookie. You created that. That's your style. But even, like, right now, the card that we had today. You could have went to Drones. It was that big. But you kept it small and
keep it to the
75 concept. People. Why do you love this shit?
Well, that shit with today, for example, was more so about just staying true to the concept.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it was like 2 years ago, like maybe winter 2015 or something like that. I started doing interviews promoting Validation 1, which we knew we wanted to create a small room series.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I started telling the fans, this is what we're gonna do, pound small room. We feel like the game needs it. The game is more so about the bigger the better, and we respect that, and we like to do that shit too. But at the same time, the game needs that small room. And I feel like that lane was open for us to really just go in there and push that a little bit more, that small room vibe again. Fast forward, we go through 5 validation cards. One of them turns out a battle like JC versus Craig Lamar. Show up versus J400. We got Money Bags versus Sire. We got battles like that in these small rooms. Mm-hmm. And we're like, man, like.
J Murder, Mr. Mills.
We like, yo, we on to something.
Yeah.
Pushing the small room shit. We could just, you know, put a little bit more money on the event and just keep going drum. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But
I'm saying, I just want the fans to know too. Even with the money, with the YouTube hit, you one of the only people who said, yo, it ain't about that. Let's do this anyway.
You know what I mean?
So I gotta salute that, man.
I had a lot of people asking us, why is this card in Funkadelic? This is probably the biggest card to ever come to Funkadelic Studios.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? and you could do the math, and you could see we still only charge people like $35. You could do the math on it.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, when we really got an idea like that, being that we have the creative space and we love doing this, of course we want to make our money back like anybody. I'm not gonna bullshit y'all. But we got that space. Shotta always says, battle rap for us is not a necessity, it's a luxury.
Mm-hmm.
That's real 100% truth. So that gives us enough space to be innovative, come up with shit, start in five, blood, sweat, and tears, Writers Volume 1, bring back Small Rooms of Validation, you know, all these different concepts, theme cards, like the last Lift a Soul.
Yeah.
It gives us the space to just have fun with this shit and do what we gotta do.
Well, y'all know, you know, we late, we gotta get out of here.
Yeah.
I know this ain't the last one of the year, correct?
You got
something
not.
Coming?
Yeah.
Okay.
The next card, the five main battles are 100% locked in. The date is locked in. The venue is locked in. It'll be back at Club Tron.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
So it's big.
Yeah, it's serious. I don't think the 1SK battle is locked in yet.
Okay.
You know, Lawrence runs that. Lawrence, I challenge you to book Nice from Jersey versus whoever you pick. Mm. Whether it's the best 1SK on RBE so far
Nice.
Or somebody else. That's my challenge to Lawrence. To make that as the sixth battle, and there's talks in the air after tonight of a surprise seventh battle.
Mm.
But the five main battles, basically the card, the main card, is 100% done and locked in. Believe me when I tell y'all that the last two times we was in drama, we gave y'all the Lift a Soul theme card and Blood, Sweat, and Tears 5, we topped both of those.
Mm-hmm.
We topped both of those cards. So I'm gonna give y'all the date real soon. Stay tuned to the channel. I'm gonna give y'all the lineup real soon after that. Even when I give y'all a date, do yourself a favor, go to Eventbrite and get a ticket. Trust me.
Facts.
Get a ticket. Trust me.
Yeah. Video on demand.
Yes, sir.
It's gonna be up tonight. Writer's Block.
Should be
one.
24 hours. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Depending on when you see this right here.
I'm gonna drop this tomorrow, so it'll be up tonight.
Tomorrow is Sunday, September 3rd. You should be able to, at Sunday, September 3rd, by the afternoon, whether it's like 4 or 5 o'clock, somewhere in that area, go to rapgrid.com.
And I promise
your pay-per-view
you.
And you will see the entire card. It might be up there for like $25, $35 or whatever. One battle alone is gonna give you your money's worth.
I promise you.
One
classics.
Battle alone.
Yo, and again, yo, like you're also one of the fastest people to uploading the video on demand footage. I can't even tell you how you do it.
Yeah.
Because you got some super fast computers and shit.
Yeah.
But
we were trying to stay within that 24
yeah,
hours.
Yeah, man, but for sure, man, if they couldn't see the event, it was worth it.
Thank
you know what I'm saying? Yo,
thank
ARP,
you.
RDE. Family.
Salute, Heavy Bags TV in the building, all that. I appreciate your support as always. You already know what it is when it comes to RBE and Heavy Bags. Other than that, appreciate all the fans, man. RBE shit, Brick by Brick shit. Yo, it's your boy. We out of here. Another one. Yeah.